Heat is on. I decided to run in the morning, and it was still hot out there.
It's going to be worse
this
week.
It was hot.
Yeah, the humidity isn't that bad. It's going to be worse this weekend. 99 degrees today in Ocala.
Wow.
Probably going to be there again tomorrow. The beach is going to be the place to be. I'm going to explain why here in a second. But look at that beautiful shot of our HD weather cam. Very hard to even find a cloud. If you look to the northwest there, that little red live bug there, you can see a little cloud. You got to look real hard. You might have to get real close to your screen and squint a little bit. But other than that, things are fairly quiet across central Florida. Let's head to the coast. Any difference? Oh, there's Jason's boat. Yeah, he's taking us out this weekend. Hey, speaking of this weekend, it's going to be a great time on the water, but please be responsible. Don't drink and boat. We've had our share of issues here of late. We want to keep everybody safe out there. Let's take a look now at satellite radar. Show you what it looks like. There's our big ridge of high pressure. Way to go, by the way, guys in the back. Love that shot. Daytona Beach, Orlando, quiet. There are a few storms up towards Jacksonville. Our late evening computer models drag this a little bit closer to us, but then have it fizzle out just north of the campus of the University of Florida. 99 down to 97. What a bargain now at 518. Right up there in Ocala, 93 for Orlando. Place to be tomorrow afternoon and all weekend along the coast, because that onshore flow will be with us as the land heats up. It creates that onshore breeze, and it's going to feel a whole lot more comfortable at the beaches than it will be towards the interior. Here's the feels-like temperature between 95 and 105 this afternoon. Daybreak temperatures, by the way, ranging from the upper 60s in our northwestern counties to the lower 70s, Sanford on south and east over towards Melbourne. There's future scan. There's that little cluster of showers and thunderstorms towards Jacksonville weakening on out. And then a slight hint for some late afternoon showers and thunderstorms, but I think the model's overdoing it for Saturday. I like what it's doing for Sunday. One or two isolated cooling thunderstorms for a few of us, but most of us will be dry this upcoming weekend. Hey, if you're a golfer tomorrow morning hitting the links, sun up 627, you're going to be in pretty good shape. Noontime temperature of 87, afternoon high temperature eastward, east Orlando, running 94 to about 95 degrees, and rain and lightning free. Now at the beaches, more specifically for Flagler Beach, 89. Surf temp 76 over towards Daytona Beach Pier. If you're doing some fishing, 91 surf temp there, 76 from the guys there this morning. And Cocoa Beach, your water temperature, 78. Your air temperature, close to 90. 94 Orlando is where we're going to be tomorrow. 99 again for Ocala. Up and down the coast from about 11:30 to about 1:30 will peak. And then that onshore flow continues to work its magic and cools us off towards mid-afternoon. Afternoon high temperatures will be running in the mid to the upper 80s after the early afternoon high temperatures. Temperatures peaking at about 90, 91 degrees. Tropics, oh yeah, he's loving this. Nice and quiet, a few tropical waves out there. But this big ridge of high pressure keeping us calm, keeping us quiet, but also keeping us hot. 7-day outlook as we reveal that for you. Afternoon high temperatures, 93, 94, 93, 94. You get the pattern. We're stuck there. Rain chances going up by next week.
It's hot and it's going to rain.